Welcome to WSO2 API Manager 4.0 Scenario Tutorials Part 5 on signing up a new user. This is a tutorial that is part of a series and can be used as a standalone tutorial on how to sign up a new user. For more details on the scenario and general prerequisites, please watch the previous videos on this series. Let's start the tutorial. Qantas allows external users to access their APIs. To take the full benefit out of these APIs, they have decided to open the registration to outside users since it can be a burden to enter all the details for every single user or consumer. Therefore, they request an approval workflow for user registration in such a way that the users will be registered to the system when a user with administrative privileges approves their registration after a manual validation of the user. By allowing external parties to register to their system under supervision, Qantas expects a higher revenue in the future. As the solution, the WSO2 API Manager 4.0 allows the users to create the accounts in the system via the developer portal using the self-registration option. It also has the user sign-up approval workflow where the admin user can approve or reject the registration request. This can be catered to the Qantas requirements. Let's try out this use case. As the first step, we need to set up the self-registration workflow. WSO2 API Manager provides extension points to trigger workflow tasks for many operations such as application creation, subscription creation, user sign-up, etc. By default, WSO2 API Manager comes with a simple approval workflow. This demo setup already comes with self-sign-up and sign-up approval workflow enabled for the Qantas tenant domain. If you need to check how to configure this flow, please refer to the enabling self-sign-up and enabling sign-up workflow documentations referred here. Let's check if we can see whether the user sign-up approval workflow executor is engaged to this flow by logging into the Qantas tenant domain's carbon management console. Let's use the username as admin@qantas.com. And use the password as admin. Onto your left panel, we have an option called Main. Under that, we have Resources. Under Resources, click on Browse. In this location search bar, let's search for the workflow extension. Click on Go. So this workflow extension is located under System, Governance, API MGT, Application Data, workflow-extensions.xml. Let's click on this display as text, and here you can see that we have many extensions options. You could see that the user sign-up approval workflow executor is now engaged to this user sign-up flow. Next, let's test the user sign-up flow. For that, let's go to the developer portal and select Qantas.com tenant. Click on the sign in button and click on the create account link. Provide any desired username. For testing purposes, I'll be using raj@qantas.com. Click on proceed to self register. And you can provide the mandatory fields here. And for password, let's provide user 123. Now click on register. So now that we have successfully registered, let's try to log into this developer portal using the newly created user. So now you can see that you're getting 403 forbidden error. This is because the user signup approval workflow is attached to this user signup flow. The user can successfully log in only if the admin approves the signup or registration request. Let's approve the signup request. For that, let's log into the admin portal. Use the admin@quantis.com as the username. And for password, use admin. So under task option, we have user creation. So now you can see the newly created user creation request has been displayed in the admin portal. Now let's try to approve this one. So the request has been successfully approved. Now let's try to log into the developer portal using the newly created user's credentials. Provide the username as raj@quantis.com and use the password user123. As you can see, we were able to successfully log in with the newly created user, and with that note, we have come to the end of this tutorial. As the next step in the upcoming videos, we'll deeply analyze and get some hands-on experience on getting the developer community involved. Thank you for watching this video, and we hope that you have learned something new and useful. We'll meet you all soon in another informative video.